Uncle Morty used to send me to the movies. Here's a nickel, kid. Cheer up and go. And though I was only 7, I discovered heaven at the RKO. Blue lights, pink lights, stars in the ceiling, an organ as big as a Buick, and a screen as tall as the Great Wall of China. Red rugs, gold stairs, porcelain angels, and everything bigger and better and larger than life. At first, I was strictly a Western man. But then, one Saturday afternoon, I saw Defender of the Crown, Warner Brothers 1941 Technicolor, starring Alan Swan. Daring, loyal, kind, but courageous. A hero as big as a Buick, with a cape, a sword, and a bevy of maidens. He was movies. Me, I was 7. And gee, he was bigger and better and larger than life. See, life wasn't capes or flashing swords or parapets. Life wasn't Alan Swan or Robin Hood. Life was your father going out for cigarettes and deciding he was going out for good. Here's a nickel, kid. Cheer up and go. Swan is playing at the RKO. But sure, it was possible. If he met my mom in 34, maybe had a fling with her in his cabana at the Chateau Marmont, there was every reason to believe that there could be the remote possibility that the man who went out for the Chesterfields wasn't my real father at all. Look, I wasn't some stupid kid whose father got tired of him and walked out. I was the bastard son of Alan Swan. Daring, loyal, kind, but courageous. A hero as big as I needed in the technicolor embrace of a maiden. Swan, my hero and possible father. He stood and he fought and he never ran. Oh no, he was bigger and better and larger than life, and he lived for me. At the RKO.